town of Strumpeth. And to sit and watch the young women go past talking and laughing down to the well with their brightly coloured water jugs. Loses something in the translation. We're going to sing three Bulgarian love songs now. And the first one is about knitting socks. Because in Bulgaria, knitting socks and giving socks is a sign of love. And so it's called, the young girl is called Rushke, who is knitting. And a young man says, "Who are you knitting the socks for? Are they for me? My friends are going to be so jealous if they're for me." And then your guy cheekily says, "And your friends will be jealous too." So it's Aimuri Rushke. Emuri Rushke, Bella Rushke, Chura, Plisi, Play, Tash. Emuri Rushke, Bella Rushke, Chura, Plisi, Play,
I can have a tea.
third Bulgarian love song. It's not about knitting. It's the last two were traditional folk Bulgarian songs. This one is a blend of Bulgarian, traditional Bulgarian folk, and modern classical Western harmonies. And it's actually what most people think about when they think of Bulgarian music. Okay, it's called Dumai Zlato. Zlato is the girl's name. And it's a modern folk song because the boy has asked Zlato if her parents have consented to him marry, and they said he's too poor. And his only option of getting money is to travel abroad. So it's quite a heartfelt song, but very beautiful, I think.
We now have, it's a popular urban song from East Georgia, and it's called Patara Gogo. And if you listen to the harmonies, you can hear there's a strong link to Middle Eastern musical traditions. It's actually quite a sad song. An anxious mother has lost her little girl who's wearing a red shirt. And you can hear the anguish in her voice rise as she cries, "Please tell me, have you seen her?"
Yeah.
is called Manavu, and it's in Hebrew. And the words are from the Old Testament, from Isaiah. And they are, how sweet on the mountains are the feet of the messenger bringing good news, proclaiming salvation, proclaiming peace. Song now, and this is about a young woman called Milka, who's very beautiful, and it's about her being kidnapped by the silk seller when she goes onto his boat to buy silks. The words say that she's kidnapped, but actually it turns out that in Bulgaria, if a couple elope because they haven't got the parents' permission to marry, the girl's family say she's been kidnapped, because it looks too bad on the family if they say she's eloped. So that's right, so it's a beautiful milk.
Hey.
songs. The first one is a Romanian lullaby called Heidi Nanny, and it's "Come hush-a-bye, Mama is rocking you. Hush, hush, Mama's little darling." Jok, which is Commie Syrian, and that's an area of Russia, so I've been told. And it's for all the grandmothers out there, because grandma hums and she sings, and the cradle creaks, and you hear the creaking going jerk, jerk, jerk. And then you can hear the frustration rising in grandma as she's desperately trying to get baby to sleep. And then we have a second verse in English, words by Nikki, but this time it's mummy struggling with baby.
Joke.
Yiddish called Ayni Luli. And it goes, sleep, sleep, my pride and joy. I will run to the market and buy you little bagels. You will grow up and be wise and great, and everyone will be envious of me.
Julian Littman and Charlie Dawes, and Julian is a member of Steli, and they'd written it for a choir. I think it was in 8 parts originally, and they never performed it. So I think they can't do it. Anyway, Julian asked us if we wanted it, and he arranged it in 4 parts for us. So it's kind of our song. It's called Sons and Daughters. And then two songs after, two English songs that don't need much introduction. They're two Beatles songs. It's Beatles Day in a couple of weeks, and we'll be singing there. So we've picked two of our favourite Beatles songs after that. So, firstly, Sons and Daughters.
All our sons,
Deity of Nana, the goddess of light and fertility. And traditionally, Georgian women have invoked Nana to protect their children from evil spirits during the time passing from wakefulness into dream time. And I'd like to dedicate this song to my lovely mum, Irene Doble, who's happily happy. She's in the audience today. And so it's Nana, my darling. The next song is called Esak Fani, This Cradle,
and it's from a Georgian circle dance song, and traditionally it's sung when putting a baby into the cradle for the first time. The song describes different cradles. There's a carved cradle with a boy carved in it, a cradle made of chestnut with the one inside running around, a cradle made of hazelnut, and the child laid within it is celebrating, and finally a cradle made of plum, and the child laying within it is made of crystal.
Called Shenkar Vinaki, which is "You Are a Vineyard."
it's a compliment.
It's actually a song which is in praise of the Virgin Mary, and it dates back at least 1,000 years. The text was actually written by King Dimitri I, who was somewhat of a poet as well as a ruler. It's really nowadays and in more recent times a song which is often sung at weddings in honour of the bride. Translation: you are a vineyard, just blossoming, young and good, springing up in Eden, a fragrant poplar growing in paradise. May God adorn you. None is more worthy of praise. You yourself are the sun, brilliantly shining.
Thank you.
And for our final song, we've chosen one of our favourites, which is a love song from Bulgaria. It's called Sunsunava, I Drink Dreams. And in the song, the singer is singing about himself and his loved one becoming two doves and then two peacocks and flying high into the sky and alighting on a vineyard. It's a kind of a in it you hear the words Zimbio, Zumbio, Makamore, blue and white hyacinths, little girl.
And thank you very much for coming this morning.
Thank you.
And thank you to our road crew.
Oh yes, that road crew.
Without whom this would not have been possible. At the beginning, so you can all join in this. We'll give you your notes.